How are you?
I'm doing okay. Busy. I've got places a little more sorted than it was.
It looks very studio-like.
I'm an adult. I know that today because I was excited about putting up a hand towel rack, hand towel holder.
Ooh, that is pretty exciting, though.
Like, oh my god, the brushed antique brass fixture, it's going to match the outlet covers I just put in.
Wow. You're so domesticated.
Hey, myself, Zad. I'm like, when you're at the point you're getting excited about bathroom fixtures, you're officially old. You're officially way too fucking old.
I knew I was old when I started wondering where teenage girls' mothers were and I left them out of the house wearing that.
Yes.
That's when I knew I was old.
Well, it's like they keep... Every generation just has to keep upping the ante. So, you know, you guys would wear the short skirts. Now they have to wear, like, you know, I think it's like maybe it's a hand towel just wrapped around that area.
Now they pretty much just wear shirts that are just long enough to cover their ass.
In about 20 years, they're just going to say fuck it and just go out and, like, you know, a G-string and that's it.
It's with my mouth safe.
They'll go out like a G-string and maybe like some masking tape here and that'll be it. That's...
They'll just wear the outfit from the Fifth Element, the bandage outfit.
Exactly, yeah.
That'll be it. They'll just wrap themselves in some Ace bandage and call it a day.
So this week, we've got a weird collection this week because some of it's actually uplifting.
Ooh.
And some of it isn't.
Oh.
Because it kind of goes back and forth with us. Let's get to it and
that's my water, not yours.
No, it's all hers. She's a cat. It's hers. No, you don't understand. She's a cat.
I do understand.
It's all hers.
I had broccoli cheese soup on Friday and she put her nose in it.
Didn't eat it, just put her nose in it. It's like, this shit's mine. You eat this because I allow it.
I don't even like it, but I'm going to stick my nose in it.
Yep.
Like just so you know who's in charge here.
She's like a schoolyard bully, I swear. All right, shall we get started?
Let's get started.
Now the cat has decided it's time to leave. Okay. Each week, Catherine, Radio Dead Air... Audience, go out in the worldwide interwebs, find all sorts of horrible stuff. Bring it back here for a little segment we like to call What the Fuck Is Wrong With You? And our very first one this week, you know, sometimes I sit and think, there's going to come a day where I'm not really going to have the show. And I'm concerned about that sometimes, you know, because you think about the future, you think maybe, you know, things are going to change. But then something happens that reminds me, nope. I am always, you know what I call this next story? Job security. Let's bring this up on screen here. They get things set up properly here. Come on, where are you?
Oh.
Yeah, you're seeing it already. Okay, here's the screen. Here we go. Let's bring it up on screen. Regulator reverses approval of powdered alcohol, or palcohol, if you will. Federal agency that originally approved reverses approval. Okay. Recently approved a new powdered alcohol, reversed its position Monday. Alcohol and Tobacco Tax and Trade Bureau approved palcohols, powdered vodka, rum, and other cocktails in error. Agency has not responded to further questions. Company makes palcohol, Tempe, Arizona-based Lip Smack LLC, said, there seemed to be a discrepancy about how much powder is in the packets, which are meant to be mixed with water. Lipsmark said it will resubmit the product for approval. Active alcohol weighs just an ounce, make it more portable than a bottle or flask of liquor. Critics argue the product is potentially dangerous. The alcohol website originally suggested that consumers bring it into college football stadiums and concerts. It also proposed adding the powder to food, recommending such combinations as vodka and eggs.
You know, as somebody who was relatively hungover on Easter morning, vodka eggs might have really helped.
I just, the website, I swear to God, and they amended it. Like, we didn't really mean that. The website noted, you can snort it.
That seems unwise.
Yes! Yes, that is what unwise was defined for. That is all. And yes, I love how they said, okay, sure. Oh, wait, no.
I kind of feel like you shouldn't snort anything.
You shouldn't. No, because that's not what your nose is for.
No. Like, I really have the opinion that you shouldn't be snorting.
Yeah, there are a lot of things I'm flexible on when it comes to the body that are, you know, things that are not supposed to be used that way. Sure, fine. But the whole snorting of things, your nose has got a very specific design. And it's not there to be a drug delivery system.
No.
It's really, because I thought
you need that for breathing.
I thought gin blossoms on your nose would be bad, but geez. But the fact that someone at the Alcohol and Tobacco Tax and Trade Bureau, somebody looked at this and said, okay, sure. And I'm sure probably after the outcry, there was the backpedaling, but the company said, Lipsmark said they are going to resubmit it.
It's a bad day when you get that mixed up with Kool-Aid. Like the kid's birthday party.
Well, no, that's a good day because the kids are suddenly much easier to manage. Except
until the puking starts.
Except you get that one belligerent 6-year-old in the background. Says, I know, Barney. I'll tell you about. Don't you tell me about Barney. Fuck Elmo. I remember Barney. I was there.
Let me tell you something. Barney's a little bitch. That kid. And then the puking starts.
Yeah. Is as if this is seems like it was custom designed for alcoholics who are trying to hide it. You know?
Yeah.
Are you drunk? No, I haven't had a drink all day. I had a taco. But I haven't had
sprinkled some seasoning on it.
See, I had taco seasoning.
What kind of seasoning? Tequila.
Tequila. This is the best kind of taco is tequila taco.
Can you imagine like Taco Bell when they give you their assortment of sauces? Would you like hot, super hot, or drunk?
Side note, we were in the grocery store this weekend, and I'm constantly amused by showing Kat stuff from America. We walked by the taco shell aisle, and there was the chocolate taco dessert kit. She's just like, oh, no. Oh, no.
Has she seen the waffle taco?
Yeah. Well, no, we haven't done that yet. I told her there are two places I'm not taking her fast food-wise because I value my intestines. That's Taco Bell and White Castle. We're not doing either of those.
I kind of dig Taco Bell now and again.
Well, I'm allergic to shitting blood.
Those Cinnabon balls are pretty amazing. Cinnaballs.
They're probably going to call it that. It's like, you know, Idiocracy. Fuddruckers.
I mean, really, shouldn't all balls be covered in cinnamon? Wouldn't it be a better world? I think it would.
Anyway, so, never let it be said that getting a position in government has suddenly will add anything to your IQ. And I think really this next story is the epitome of that. Do you understand what parts per million means?
Yes.
And you don't work in government.
I'm attacking my toes.
I'm not even any kind of scientist, and yet I understand the concept of parts per million. I understand the concept of dilution. But apparently, the Water Bureau Administrator in Portland does not. Portland Reservoir urination case, prosecution, cleaning, and cost. Are you going, but wait a second. Portland Water Bureau Administrator David Schaff stands by a decision to drain 38 million gallons of water from a reservoir at Mount Tabor where a teenager peed Wednesday morning despite test results showing the water is clean. My customers expect they will receive water that hasn't been deliberately contaminated. Chef said, I can do that. Draining and cleaning the reservoir won't cost the Bureau any additional money. He said, yeah, I doubt that.
Yeah.
Because draining 38 million of gallons of water through the serious sewer system will cost the Environmental Services Bureau a little more. Spokesperson Link Mann said a financial analyst at the Bureau estimated the influx of clean water will cost $21,926 taxpayer dollars. Now, this is a reservoir. It is an open-air reservoir.
Which means all kinds of stuff is peeing in there.
Yes. Dogs are coming up and just peeing in the water. Badgers are... frogs are constantly pissing in this water. Birds are flying over and shitting in the water.
Yes,
ducks. Ducks, not only... they're not just peeing in the water. They're fucking in this water. Okay?
Okay.
You know, it's lots of contamination. Lots of contamination. But when we're talking 38 million gallons, the dilution is such to the point where you will not even be able to identify individual molecules as pee anymore. It will be just so spread out. Finding a pee molecule will be like a needle in a haystack. I just...
is there such a thing as a pee molecule?
I don't know. Is there? Do you guys... is there such a thing as a molecule OP?
I don't think so.
I don't know. I'm not a scientist, but I do understand parts per million, you know? And what this says to me is...
is that like the God molecule? The P molecule?
What this says to me is this does not say to me, you know, this is a responsible decision. What this tells me what's going to happen is now that it's revealed that they will drain the reservoir anytime someone is caught peeing in it, the new pastime in Portland is going to be peeing in the reservoir. It's going to be a Friday night, 11 p.m. Kids are like, what should we do tonight? We can go catch a show or, you know, we can go have a party. No, no. Let's get a video camera and go up to the reservoir and pee in it and put that shit on YouTube. Yeah. They'll drain it tomorrow. It'll be hilarious.
Probably, and then complain about the taxes.
I know. It's 38 million gallons just because deliberately contaminated. Are you going to find the ducks? Are you going to find every single fucking pigeon or seagull who went over this thing and dropped a deuce and, like, try to lock them up?
Maybe. A conspicuous waste of taxpayer dollars.
Is this Maine or... yeah, where was this? This is Portland, but they don't... I think this is Oregon. Yeah, this is Portland, Oregon. It just... It's piss per million. Nice, Emily Dash. Piss per million.
Why are you peeing in the reservoir anyway? Like, don't do that.
You gotta go, you gotta go. At least they're not pooping in the street. You gotta say that. At least they didn't poop in the reservoir.
But don't do that.
I know. But nonetheless, it's not that big a fucking deal. It's just pee. I swear to God, you will get worse in your life just by walking out through the rain. We polluted shit way too much.
Well, and they say, like, they allow a certain amount of...
rat droppings in cereal?
Yeah, in food, yeah. And insect legs.
There's a certain
sort of thing.
Ladies and gentlemen, at some point in your life, you've eaten a rat turd. You might not even known it, but you have.
It was probably at McDonald's.
Yeah, it's probably. So.
They just call it a McRib there.
Oh. Okay. I guess our next story is another example of proportionate response. Air drop something like out the window while you're driving on accident, like something like something important, or like papers have blown out of your window. I had that happen when I was in college. You know, I had my windows down, and like a paper blew out the window, and I was like, "Fuck!"
No,
on the highway, and I was like, "Fuck! Do I stop and get it back?" And this is before, you know, ubiquitous printing everywhere. This is like you had to go get that shit done, printed. I was like, do I go back and get it, or do I be late for class? And it's one of those, but I thought to myself, no, I won't go back and get it because I like living. The idea of chasing a piece of paper across a four-lane highway. Well, apparently these people's survival instincts are not as finely as finely tuned as mine, I would say. Man goes on Broad Street subway tracks to retrieve orange.
Orange? You can get another orange, dude.
And now this is a story actually about two people who were on the tracks this week. Two different passengers ended up on the subway tracks yesterday. In one day, I gotta say. First man to head on the tracks on Wednesday fell off the tracks at the 34th Street station. Which means we can go ahead and assume he's a Penn or Drexel student. Oh, funny. This is from Philadelphia. He was checking his cell phone and just went right into him. And you can watch him right there. There he goes. Checking his cell phone and boom! Right over the side. Now, that's stupid, but that is an accident. He did not actually intend to go down there.
But you gotta watch where you're going down there.
Well, the next one... The Broad Street line, the Ellsworth Federal stop, a man went on the subway tracks to retrieve an orange. There he goes. Watch it. Drops the orange. Looks over the side. Gets down. There he goes. To get the orange off the train. Not only is there the concern that a large metal speeding object might make contact with your squishy, fleshy body. There's also electricity down there.
Did you see the kid who was trying to take a selfie in front of a speeding train
and
the conductor
boom!
Tried to kick him in the head?
Yeah, the conductor kicked him in the head as the train was going by. It was really pretty special. It was great. But this one, there's...
Don't fuck with trains, people.
There's
don't fuck with trains.
You know what? You know what the third rail is, right?
Yes, we used to have, like, once a year in school, because we just got the third rail when I was in, like, fifth grade or something in my town. So, like, every year we had a full school assembly about the third rail.
Yeah, it's that if you touch the third rail, that's the one that's highly electrified. If you touch the third rail, it's the last thing you're touching in your entire fucking life.
Yes, it is. Unless you're touching a large speeding train
while
it splatters you.
Yeah. For an orange. I mean, that's... I'm sitting there going, well, that's 25 cents I'm not getting back.
Yeah, unless it's, like, the last orange in the world, in which case the trains probably aren't running anyway.
No. That's the point where, you know, the Statue of Liberty's blown up.
Unless you're Will Smith and it's I Am Legend and that is the last orange, just let it go.
He could quite literally, after dropping that orange, just do a good sweep of the platform and find enough change to buy another orange on the ground at that platform. Easily. I guarantee you. He could come up with a full dollar. He could get two, three oranges, replace that orange.
Yeah.
Just, you have to wonder at what point, he just thought, well.
I mean, it's not like he dropped a Pepsi down there.
Really? Because if I'm going to have to put you as a eulogy on this show because you, your ass dropped a Pepsi down the fucking subway, I'm going to be ashamed of you. I think we'll all be a little ashamed of you.
Yeah, I don't want my eulogy to be on this bit.
So, this is...
By the way, tonight, the reason Tara's not on the show this week.
Yeah. Okay. I don't have kids. All right, when your sister's out with your nephew, does she keep a pretty close eye on him?
Oh, yeah.
So, she knows pretty approximately where he is at all times.
Yes.
When they're in public. I would think that would be a very important, in this day and age, element of being a parent, to know where your kids are.
Yes.
That's why, and this is not the first time this has happened. We've had this on the show before. I don't understand how although the kids, goddamn, they amaze me in the ability to do this. This is a classic case of watch where the fuck your children are. Missing boy found in claw machine at bowling alley. And look, he is happy. He's not upset at all.
The local news station that covered this on the radio kept on, every time they ran this story, they would play the sound from Toy Story.
The claw. Oh. The claw. Lincoln, Nebraska. A child reporting missing by his mother was found safe inside a claw crane machine at a nearby bowling alley. According to KETV, the mother, child's mother called police at 5:30 p.m. when she discovered her three-year-old boy was not inside her apartment. Bowling alley across the street, a little boy was found sitting with stuffed animals inside the claw crane machine. Police called the vendor, who quickly arrived and let the boy out. While police were investigating...
Did they make her try and win him? Like, well, listen, ma'am, we understand your son is in there, but you could have any of these beautiful stuffed animals.
You want him back. You want him back. You got to get some signals.
You
got
to grab the claw, you know? Yeah. That's how it works.
Just see it gripping onto his little head, picking him up. I am constantly amazed little bastards keep getting in there.
I know.
That is some magical shit. Oh, yeah, they're talking
and
about...
the kid, like, he, like, got out of their home. Like, she had to put a... She put a chain lock on the door above where he can reach because he just left the home.
Yeah, he just walked out. He just left.
And went to the bowling alley and climbed inside the claw. Like, that's terrifying. Can you imagine, like, you walk out of the room to make little Jimmy his lunch... You come out, and little Jimmy's gone.
That is a brilliant...
He's inside the fucking claw machine. Like, how does that even occur to a kid?
That is a brilliant... That kid's a genius. He's going to cure cancer someday.
Or be Lex Luthor.
Yeah, something like that. Because
stop trying to bite me. Stop it. I'm trying to pet you. Stop trying to bite me.
I'm
having some kitty issues here.
You know, honestly, if I knew a kid that could do that, I would be constantly taking him to, like, places with the claw machine. Be like, okay, get in there and throw me down that one, the shit in the box. Don't fuck the little toy. There's a Game Boy in there. Give me that shit. Okay,
give you got the iTunes gift card.
Yeah, seriously, throw me the iTunes gift card. That's a talent in this day and age. That kid could be making mad.
When I was in junior high, we always had roller skating parties, and I can't roller skate. I've never been able to roller skate, but I would go to the roller skating party, and I would make a ton of money because I got really good at the claw machine. So, like, it was $1 to play, so you'd tell me what you wanted and give me $2, and I'd win it in one and pocket the extra dollar. And I'd walk out of there having made, like, $10.
People are saying, I wonder how many people, yeah, it was like, I wonder how many people before they went and told the cops got the kid to drop shit down the chute.
Yeah, right.
Oh my God, there's a kid, that Duck Dynasty plushie, could you, okay, yeah, I'll be right back. I saw that in the claw machine this weekend, Duck Dynasty
really?
Plushies.
They have figurines?
No, they're plushie dolls. They're like, what kid wants to go to sleep with, like, one of the Duck Dynasty guys?
Oh.
I would feel very unsettled by that.
Yeah.
So this next story is kind of a feel-good story, because it's very rare we have a feel-good story about these with kids. Normally when these stories involve kids, they're the kind that just make us go, oh no, oh, what's wrong with you? Like, their parents are getting in a fight at the Chuck E. Cheese. And I almost used a story this week about parents at an Easter egg hunt. One of the parents pushed the kid out of the way, and then they got into a fight.
Don't we get one of those, like, every year?
I know. But no, I wanted to go with the feel-good one tonight. And this one, these kids are just the best fucking thing ever. I wouldn't, if I had kids, I wouldn't mind these being my kids, honestly. Twins 7 attack carjacker with fists and rubber snake. Car thief was forced to pull over after a couple miles in the stolen vehicle because twin boys, age 7, who were in the car, attacked him. One of the boys was punching the man in the face. The other was hitting him with a rubber snake. Car was swiped from in front of the home of Lucia Lozada Thursday as the mother was standing just feet from her vehicle. Her twin sons and 1-year-old buckled in the car as the family ready to go to church. Father had gone back in the house to get the baby a bottle. Lucia saw the man before he took the car. She recognized him from around the neighborhood and even waved to him. Before she could do anything, he jumped in the car and drove away.
And then her kids kicked his ass.
They kicked his ass! The distraught mother called police, who rushed to the scene. Within 10 minutes, her boys had got the carjacker to pull over and drop the boys and baby brother off a few miles away. You know, that's... They fucking awesome kids. I jumped up and like, fuck you, Zarkar! I just see one back there with a snake going, get the fuck out of my fucking car!
With the rubber snake.
Yes! And you know when this guy gets to prison, everyone's going to know the story.
Yeah.
That he got his ass kicked by a pair of 7-year-olds. And you know, they say the TV shows make the kids violent. They were always worried about Power Rangers when I was a kid. It was going to make kids violent. It seems to be working in this case. You know? It's morphin' time, motherfucker! Get the fuck out! Because you normally read these stories about how, oh my god, the kids were stuck in the car with the carjacker. This time they're like, uh-oh! You ain't doing that shit! I'm proud of these kids. These are awesome kids. These are badass kids! That guy was probably not expecting that.
No, he's probably like, eh, well, but who steals a car with kids in it?
Especially when they know you! They've seen you around the neighborhood enough to wave at you!
Yeah.
You idiot!
But, like, you're stealing a car.
Yeah.
Those are kids. You have to maintain those. You can't just dump those when you dump the car.
I know, yeah, it's... They're not going to just, they're not just going to sit there and be like, oh, it's a ride. Okay, we'll hang. We'll chill. You put on Barney. We put on Elmo. We'll be cool. Play the banana song, banana phone. We'll sing banana phone. You got Raffy? We'll sing banana phone. No, they don't do that. In this case, they kick your ass.
And kids are feisty. No. Like my nephew's 8 and I don't think I'd piss him off.
Your nephew's 8 and he throws shit at the ceiling fan to see it knocked around the room.
He puts my hippos up there. Yeah. He got a little parachute man for in his Easter basket and he's finding higher and higher things to throw it off of.
Oh god. I did the exact same thing when I was a kid. I got the parachute man. I was at that point, I'm like, you know, I could probably get up on the roof. There's a ladder just over. I could probably get on the fucking roof.
He built a car out of a hand truck today because he had the day off school.
Now that was a story about kids being awesome, being daring and awesome. But there is a line. There is a line when daring and stupidity It's sort of like one of those, you know, bell curve things. It's daring, 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 stupid. And this would definitely be it. Because I don't know how... I don't know what step two of this plan was. Teen survives flight to Hawaii in Jet's wheel well.
Oh my god, I heard about this kid.
Aviation experts call it a miracle. The FBI says a 16-year-old boy stowed away in the wheel well of a flight from California to Hawaii and survived. Unidentified teen survived the trip halfway across the Pacific Ocean unharmed despite frigid temperatures at 38,000 feet and a lack of oxygen. FBI spokesman Tom Simon said the kid's lucky to be alive. Simon said security footage from the San Jose airport verified the boy was from Santa Clara, California, hopped the fence to get to Hawaiian Airlines Flight 45. Child had run away from his family after an argument. Simon said when the flight landed in Maui, the boy hopped down from the wheel well and started wandering around the airport grounds.
I can't believe this kid survived this. Like, one, how do you not fall out? 5 hours in there. Like, the temperature, the air pressure, like...
Temperatures can reach 40 degrees below zero.
This might be Superman.
He's not being charged with a crime. He's being handed over to Child Protection. But Jesus Christ!
Because, like, they don't depressurize that area.
I got in fights with my parents, and I did, like, I'm a runaway from home when I was a kid. And I understand, home life can be kind of bad, especially when you're 16 and you're leaving. That could be a nasty situation. But if you're, this is not a good plan. Maybe a bus, maybe getting on a bus is a better plan. It's not a great plan. But the wheel well of an airplane.
Yeah, a bus is a lot less likely to kill you.
I know they say airplane travel is the safest way to travel. But they don't mean, you know what, it's like the old George Carlin joke. He says, get on the plane, get on the plane. He said, fuck you, I'm getting in the plane. Evil Knievel can get on the plane. I'm getting in the plane. There seems to be much less wind in here. Because, Jesus, you can't take a bus to Hawaii. Boat.
Boat. Bus.
Boat.
Walk.
Now, what's also amazing here is this guy, this kid, 16 years old, mostly grown, got right the fuck through security and on a plane.
Well, the thing is, like, no, because how did he even get there? Because they don't...
He hopped
like,
a fence.
You don't board... Yeah, but you don't... Oh, okay.
He hopped a fucking fence.
Because, you know, you don't board outdoors anymore for the most part.
We're all scared about terrorism and bombing and people getting stuff past security. This kid hopped a fence and got inside the fucking plane. Had he had nefarious intent, that would not be a plane anymore. You think maybe instead of making us take off our shoes and trying to feel up our crotches, you could make sure people don't hop the fence?
I'm just more amazed that this kid survived this.
I know, Jesus!
Like, that seems, like, pretty...
He should not be alive!
No.
If he not survived, I would not be covering this story. I swear to you.
Right.
But he did, and that's kind of... Jesus, dude! Are you an X-Man?
That's what I'm saying.
No! Do you have, like, claws in your hands?
The mutant uprising might have begun.
Seriously, Jesus.
Okay, don't dig your claws into my leg, please. You can come up.
Apparently the easy way to get through security now is instead of standing in the line to have them take pictures of you naked through your clothes, is instead of dealing with that, just buy your ticket, then hop the fence. And if anybody complains, you say, I bought a ticket. I'm supposed to be here. I just didn't want you touching my junk.
I wouldn't recommend that.
I know, probably wouldn't recommend that either. Still. That's just, fuck. The odds of a person surviving that long of a flight at that altitude are very remote. I mean, you're actually talking about altitudes that are well above the altitude of Mount Everest. A lot of people would only have useful consciousness for a minute or two at that altitude. For somebody to survive multiple hours with that lack of oxygen and that cold is just miraculous. This boy...
Do you think he's going to have like some kind of permanent brain damage?
No, apparently he seems fine.
From lack of oxygen to the brain for so long? Like...
Apparently he seems fine. Everybody says he's okay.
That's weird. We're gonna find out he's like an evil alien or something.
Yeah, I know. He's not of this earth. Mm-mm. So I guess the first thing we learned this week is if you are in a bad home life situation and you need to get away from it. Well, first there are hotlines. First of all, our responsibility is, you know, I guess...
theyarenotpriceline.com.
They're not Priceline, no. And...
for God's sakes, don't do this.
Don't do this. Don't. Also, the TSA. Fuck me! It's like every other week we find some way the TSA just fucks up. Just hop a fence.
Well, let's be honest. Like, who thinks that someone's gonna do that?
Terrorists would hop a fence! They don't even have to worry about the security at all.
Yeah, I guess if they're not taking the flight, they can just attach something to the wheel and...
Exactly. Hop the fence. That's some scary shit. I just... We learned this week that you should probably, in a crime situation, be wary of kids because they will kick your ass.
Kids will fuck you right up.
Because
they will not feel bad about it.
When they're under 10 years old, they don't quite grasp. They don't understand death yet.
And I'm here to tell you, those rubber snakes hurt. You get whacked with one of those, you are not going to enjoy it.
They're hopped up on the sugar. They don't realize their own mortality. And
what they're thinking is, how would Phineas and Ferb handle this? And then it's on.
I think I've told this story before. Friends of mine in the cam way back, they had a little, like five, I think Zach was five at the time. And I was over hanging out at their place one time, and I stood up, and the kid runs at me, full force, fist extended, right to the joy bag. And as I'm falling over, he happily proclaims to the world, I'm Batman!
That's amazing.
Kids will kick your ass. We've also learned they're much smart. These little bastards are incredibly smart. They 3 years old, got into the claw machine. That's some impressive shit right there, man.
And one of the stories I heard said they let him pick whichever toy he wanted.
Because at that point, you should be like, you're just...
Just take one.
You earned it, dude. You totally earned that shit.
Yeah.
They gotta put like some sort of mesh or some sort of gate on there to keep the kids from climbing in there.
Like a wall of vegetables.
we learned that there are times you just gotta let it go. Determine the value of an item based on the value of your life.
Yeah, and if your life is worth less than an orange to you, there are hotlines.
Yeah, I know. If I drop, like, a check for $5,000 down there, even though they could make me out a new check, I'd have to sit and think for a second about jumping down there. But an orange!
Quit it.
That's, you know, you can get your citrus in other ways.
Have you noticed that the more times you say the word orange, the weirder it sounds?
Yeah, orange.
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 Zorange. Sounds like an alien word.
Door hinge.
The cat is trying to rip the skin off my arm right now. Stop that. Because yes, go play with your string.
We've learned that if you are going to be in charge of something related to science, maybe you should learn it.
Yes.
It doesn't hurt. It's not painful, I promise.
But just, don't pee in the reservoir. It's just rude.
Yeah, don't pee in the reservoir. That's... Of course, you can probably expect this is going to happen a lot more. Just see if they'll drain the fucker again. It's going to be like... It's going to be the new pastime. It's pissing in the reservoir.
Probably, because humans are fucking savages.
Instead of having the 5K run, they're just going to have, like, people line up and piss in the reservoir. For charity.
I don't think that counts as cardio.
It does not. And finally, we've learned this week that I have job fucking security. Because just when we think people can't do anything stupider, there will always
be stupider.
Because I know that powdered alcohol is going to get reapproved.
I'm looking forward to it.
I'm waiting for the first story of someone who mixes.
Drop it right in my can of Pepsi every day. And I'm going to enjoy life more.
I'm waiting for someone to mix cocaine, meth, and powdered alcohol and snort it all at once. I'm waiting. That's going to happen.
Can we do that on the air?